will now be done by them. And it's in Acts chapter number 2 that the church is born into the earth. The physical Christ has ascended into heaven, but his mission is now being carried out through his new body, the ecclesia, the called out ones, the church of the living God. And it's through this new body, the church, that the work of Christ will be done through the Spirit of God that's living inside us. The Spirit of God that lives in us and works through us. It's through this new body, the church, that Christ's work will be done. And can I tell you parenthetically, that's why it gets on my nerves and it bothers me when I hear people say the church is no longer necessary. Or that the church is irrelevant, or that I love Jesus, but I can't stand the church. That gets on my nerves, or those who are intent on criticizing the church, those who get on Facebook and social media each and every day and talk about what the church ain't doing. It gets on my nerves, dear friends, because you can say what you will about the church, but the Bible lets us know that it's the church that Christ loves. The Bible lets us know that it's the church that is the bride of Christ. The Bible lets us know that the church is his body. As a matter of fact, the Bible you read and the Bible I read lets us know that it's the church that Jesus Christ is coming back for. Let me just say parenthetically on tonight that I love the church. I thank God for the church. Again, I know it's popular nowadays to bash the church and to criticize the church and to down the church, but I thank God tonight for the church. Can I testify for you more tonight? Because it was in the church that I got saved. It was in the church that I was nurtured. It was in the church that I met a man named Jesus. As an 8-year-old little boy, talk back to me tonight if you can. I thank God.
Tonight, that throughout Acts chapter number 2, Luke repeatedly
that these people in the text had been together for a long time.
Yes.
The 120 were together for 50 days after the ascension of Jesus Christ. Then 3,000 folk joined the church. And verse 46 says that they stayed in the church for days after that. They were continually in the church. They were continually together. They kept on coming to church. Listen, I don't care what century you live in. People are people. And one of the things, dear friends, one of the things tonight, that after a few days with these people, that they would have got tired of one another. No doubt, somebody must have thought to themselves, like some of y'all are looking at me right now, somebody must have thought to themselves, it's time for me to go home. Or I could have skipped church all tonight, but your Bible says that they stayed in the church for an unspecified period of time. In fact, the text says they were present. Let me memorize that thing for y'all. The Bible says they kept on coming to church. They kept on showing up at the church. I'm sure there were days when they wanted to stay home. I'm sure there were days when they wanted to take some time off. I'm sure there were days when they wanted to sleep in. I'm sure there were days when they wanted to watch football or go to the high school football game on a Friday night or watch the basketball game on the television. But the Bible says they kept on coming to church. Which says to me that the Holy Spirit wasn't just in the room, but that the Holy Spirit was down inside people. The text says that they kept on showing up to the church. They were present when they were supposed to be present. They were accounted for when the role was taken. They were on duty when they were assigned for duty. When a meeting was called at the church house, they were at the church house. It didn't matter what time of day or what day it was. When they were supposed to be at church, they were at church. It was a faithful fellowship. Somebody shout faithful. That's right. It was a faithful fellowship made up of faithful people who came together with a singular purpose of worshiping and serving a faithful God. Okay, let me cut across the field. Let me tell y'all something tonight. God can do a whole lot with some faithful people. God can work wonders with a few faithful people. I discovered, I'm 40 years old, but I've been preaching almost 20 years. Amen. I've been pastoring a long time. And I discovered this, dear friends, that you don't always have to be the best educated. You don't always have to be the best looking. You don't always have to be the most talented. You don't always have to be the most gifted. But if you can learn how to be faithful, then faithfulness will take you where your education and your look and your talent and your gifts can't take you. Because God, I discovered, blesses faithful people. Many times, the only thing necessary for you and I to do what God wants us to do and to get the blessing that God wants for us to have is we got to learn how to just show up when it's time to show up. My daddy taught me a long time ago when I was a little boy that most of the battles in life can be won simply by showing up. Okay, let me see if I can bring home where you live. Pastor Dipper, every year around this time, I get a letter at the church from the Augusta Lincoln League. Every year, I don't get this letter, but every year, around this time of the year, I get a letter from the Augusta Scholarship. And the letter they send to me explains to us what the scholarship is all about. It says they give scholarships to kids in college. It's intended to help kids in college with scholarship money. But now here's the thing about the letter that trips me up each and every time I read it. The letter says that if a student just shows up, that a student gets a scholarship. Now, the first time I got that letter, the first time I saw that letter, I had to call the number on the letter to make sure I was reading that thing right. I was like, hold on. You don't have to apply? No. All right, hold on. So you're telling me beef?
Alright.
They're like,
no.
Okay. Don't have to apply, don't have to be. I don't know what you said. What about your braids? Braids got to be right, surely. When you get the sauce, no, braids ain't got to be right.
Yeah.
I know, you got to fill out the FAFSA form.
Oh, yeah.
Federal application for federal student aid. You got to fill that out, surely. You got to fill that thing out. Say, no, ain't got to fill out FAFSA for none of that. We got none of that. All you got to do is show up. Language of the day, that word accord in the Greek, you understand, is the word you miss the significance of the text if you don't remember that these were not necessarily like-minded people. Because you got to remember tonight that this gathering was comprised of people from different areas of the world, folks with different experiences, people with different cultures, of different cultures, people of different points of view, all in the same place. Now, not only did you have Jews in the house, in the room, but you also had Gentile converts in the room from all over the Roman Empire. In fact, the text tells us in Acts 2 and verse number 9 exactly who was in the room. You had Jews from Jerusalem and Judea. You had people from Parthia, which is modern day Iraq and Iran. You had folk from Medea and Mesopotamia and Cappadocia, and folk different Asia Major, Asia Minor, folk from Pontus, from Egypt, from Libya, from Cyrene. All of the folk were in the room together. And the Bible says they were all on the same page, going in the same direction with a singular vision. Different people, of course, so they had different ways of doing things, which means there was no way that they agreed on everything. But they understood that even though we may not agree on everything, we're in this thing together. So let's work together so we can move things forward.
Yes,
and can I tell you tonight, that's a church that God can bless. That we may not tell even all the time. Listen, we may not always agree on the same thing, but at the end of the day, we're all on the same team. And everybody on the team has a part to play. It doesn't matter what your ministry title is or your position is. At the end of the day, everybody in the church ought to be moving in the same direction. Okay, this is where we live. Anybody ever seen the movie Drumline? Nick Cannon plays Devin Miles. Drumline,
yeah.
Devin Miles, who kept on trying to do his own thing,
yeah,
in the band. Kept on trying to be the star of the show,
uh-huh,
in the band. Kept trying to show everybody up in the band. And yet to be reminded, Dr. Lee was the name,
yeah,
and be reminded by the band leader that there's one band and one sound. Worship makes you more dignified, while being more expressive in worship practical proposition, and I get out of here, because I made an observation over the years.
Uh-huh.
I made an observation, been in church a long time, and I made an observation that by and large, it's the expressive churches that are the growing churches.
Now, I'm not saying
that a church, the churches that are not expressive can't grow. I'm not saying that. But what I am saying is that there's something about coming to church. Something about coming to a church where the people in the church don't mind giving God praise.
Yes.
I get all kinds of, I preach in churches just about every week. There's something about being in the house of God with the people who don't mind giving God some praise. Church is a good church. Now, I want be a favorite church. Because I discovered in my years of walking with the Lord that when you got God's favor on your life, God's favor, God's grace, God's favor can take you where your gifts, amen, and your resume, and your connections, and your money, where it can't take you. I'm just telling you, listen. I want God's favor on my life.
Amen.
I want God's favor on my church. And I believe this folk in Valley Fair tonight, as we celebrate 125 years. Say, you know what? You want God, more of God's favor.
More
of God's favor.
Yes, yes.
Well, here's the word I leave with you. You want more of God's favor, you got to keep on coming to church.
Uh-huh.
You got to keep on being faithful. I know I'm singing to the choir on tonight, but tell your brother, your sister, your cousin, them that went to church on tonight. Tell them, if you want God's favor, you got to be faithful.
Uh-huh.
On God's favor, we gotta be functional. One man, one Sabbath.
Yes.
We're all on the same team. We want God's favor, we gotta be a church that no matter what's going on in the world,
yes. Yes.
Can I say it like I feel it?
Yes.
No matter what's going on in the world, and we're the honor and the praise. I don't care what y'all took or what's going on out there on the street or in the sanctuary. I didn't come for that. I came to give God the glory and honor. Keep on being further. Do those things. Bible lessons done that will have God's favor. Let's give God praise on tonight. God, we thank you tonight for this word. God, your word is a lamp unto our feet, it's a light unto our path. God, we bless you, God, for this wonderful opportunity to gather in this place to hear from heaven. God, I pray on tonight that you will bless these your children, God. God, I pray as they celebrate 125 years that their testimony will be as the saints old say, down through the years, the Lord has been good to us. But God, I pray as they celebrate the past, that they celebrate but not be stuck in the past. And believe and know and trust that as good as these past years, 125, as good as they have been, God has even better for the Valley Fair Church. God, I thank you for this pastor, God. I thank you for the vision that he has, amen, for this community, God. I thank you for the anointing down on the inside of him, God. I thank you for these, your faithful children that are in the house of God over Friday night. God, I pray that you will bless them for their obedience on tonight, being faithful to the assignment and being faithful to come into the house of God. God, we love you and we thank you. It's in Jesus Christ's name we pray, and the people of God said amen, amen, and amen. Come on, give God the best praise.
Saith the Lord. plans for your good, not your harm. God's got some good plans for us. Let us bow down. God, our gracious Heavenly Father, we come now to thank you. God, we first want to thank you for the word that you have given us tonight. How you spoke through your servant, oh God. And Father, we thank you for reminding us that if we want to be blessed, we've got to be faithful. We've got to be a team. And we've got to be on one accord. Father, we thank you now. And God, before you act, we ask you for anything else. God, we want to ask you to look down upon your servant. The one who stood on the wall and the one who poured out what you gave him to us. God, we ask that you would replenish what he gave 100-fold. And Father, that you would strengthen him, that you would bless him, oh God. That you would continue to lay wisdom upon him, oh God. That you will continue to give him boldness, oh God, to speak what thus saith the Lord. God, we not only ask that you would bless him, but that you would bless his family, oh God, and his church family, oh God. Oh, Father, we thank you now for sending this man's servant this way, oh God, that we might be blessed, oh God. And God, we'll continue to lift him in prayer. And Father, we pray for those now under the sound of my voice, dear Father. We all stand in need of something, God. But before we start asking you for anything, God, we want to say thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you. You woke us up this morning. We were clothed in our right mind. God, you blessed us with the activities of our limbs. God, you carried us all through the day, not allowing any hurt, harm, or danger to come upon us, oh God. And then, God, you allowed us to be in this praying spot. One more time. God, we don't know what the next few minutes may hold. We don't know what the next few hours may hold. But right now, while we have this chance, God, we lift our voice in thanks. We lift our voice in praise, God. We lift our voice in adoration, God. Because you are an awesome God. So, God, we pray now that whatever the need is, God, you've already promised in your word that you'll meet and supply our every need. Whatever it is, oh God, we're going to thank you in advance. God, I'm thanking you. I may not have the blessing in my hand, but God, I'm thanking you for it in advance. My healing may not have come yet, God, but I'm thanking you in advance. God, my financial breakthrough has not shown up yet, but I'm going to thank you in advance. God, my children are not doing exactly what I desire that they do, but God, I'm praying and I'm thanking you in advance that you'll bring them home. Thank you, Father. And Father, we bless your name. Dear Father, for this house. Father, I not only pray for those that are here, I pray for those that are not here, for whatever their reasons might be, oh God. Touch them, God, like only you can. For it is in the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. And amen. Come on, bless the Lord as you go back to your seat. Bless the Lord as you go back to your seat. Bless the Lord for this man's servant that stood on the wall and spoke what thus saith the Lord. Amen. 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 Come on, bless him. Bless him. Bless him. Amen. 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 I was about to ask you, did you enjoy the message? Don't answer that. Don't answer that. Don't answer that. Don't answer that. Because I thought about it. Enjoy signifies that we're being entertained. Did you receive? Because that signifies that you heard something that would cause you to want to do and to be better. So if you really received something tonight, I'm going to ask you to do something. I'm going to ask you to get on your feet, and I'm going to ask you to bless God for this man's servant who is pouring out to us tonight. I know the church is not full, but I believe you all have to get on board. I can be louder than that all by myself. I believe you're going to praise God for what God has done through this church. Amen. 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 We're not going to prolong the time. Dr. Miller, bless you.
Bless.
Thank God for you.
Amen.
I'm going to go ahead and do this publicly, so you know. June 8th, check your calendar for me. June 8th, 7 o'clock, first night of our spring revival. June 8th, 7 o'clock. Let me know so I can write it down and eat now. I don't want to put a pencil and erase it. Okay. And if you're free and if you don't mind coming back over this way, we would love to be revival. Amen. I thought I'd go ahead and do that now. Sometimes when you ask people publicly, they don't say no too quick. They'll check it out. Amen. But we're not going to prolong the time. Thank you, Valor Fair. Those of you that are here, share what you heard with somebody.
Yes.
Because although we are blessed, be faithful. Be on one accord. And give God praise together. Amen. So we're going to ask Dr. Miller if he would come back now and he would have his final say, that he would dismiss us in his own way.
Amen.
And the people of God said amen.
Amen.
Let's stand to be dismissed. Thank you again so much for your gracious invitation to share in this pre-anniversary service and celebrated within 25 years. I do count it an honor and a privilege.
Mm-hmm.
And I pray for the remainder of your celebration that be joyous and be refreshing. Again, thank you, Pastor Nicholas. And I thank you, Mr. Lewis and Tyson, for being here tonight. So we'll be soon. So maybe I put my phone tonight.
Yeah.
Right. So I'll make sure. I put my phone over, right?
I'll let you know.
About like me, I'm the same way. Amen. I will mess up something quick, so I gotta check with somebody else. Make sure I got the date right.
Oh,
I'm
gonna
name them all wrong.
June 8th. Yeah.
Okay, I'll make sure that Elim Church talk on June 8th. We'll be here. Amen. I'm over there tonight. They must be at the football game. We've got to hear that right. To share on tonight. Right hand of faith, here's my prayer for you on tonight. My prayer is that the Lord God will bless you and keep you. That he will make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. That the Lord will turn his blessed face in your direction and give you peace. My prayer for you tonight is that God will bless you in your going out and in your coming in your labor and in your leisure, in your basket and in your store, in your down city and in your uprising. My prayer is that God will make you the head and not the tail. Above only, not beneath. A lender, not a borrower. First, not last. On the top, not on the bottom. May God bless you, your friends, and your family real good. Amen. May these next few days some of the best days of your entire life. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray and ask these things. And people of God said amen.
Amen.
God bless you. You're